Howdy folks, Nelson here. We're going to be reviewing the Atari Paddle Tennis Type Plug and Play, released by Jack Specific. Plug and Play TV Games back in around 2004. Yeah, this is one of the other plug and plays I got with the system. It's pretty interesting. Not many plug and plays actually have the paddle controller. Like, how many plug and plays have this? None of them. Pretty much none of them. There are a couple of varieties of this one. There is one that comes out with at least another controller, so you can play two-player. However, this is of the one-player variety, which is quite disappointing. It has a nice lovely button at the top, and it has a little menu button there. It also has a LED to let you know if it's been powered or not, which is a good thing. I like it when plug-and-plays have LEDs. When they don't have LEDs in it and it doesn't work, that requires a lot of effort, because that means I've got to pop out my multimeter and I've got to figure out whether this thing's actually being supplied power or not. And I hate troubleshooting. It came out in about 2004. It would have been sold by retailers like Argus and other retailers, and probably Walmart in America. I read on the internet that it was sold there. Apparently there's 13 games on this system. Pong, Night Driver, Warlords, Arcade Warlords, Demons to Diamonds, I have no idea what that is, Breakout, Super Breakout, Circus Atari, Street Racer, Steeplechase, Video Olympics, and Canyon Bomber. Half of those games I have no idea what the heck they are, but apparently they're all licensed games, with a couple of them being actual arcade games such as Arcade Warlords, which is pretty interesting. So yeah, let's go see what this thing can do. Hello and welcome to the Atari Paddle Plug and Play. Here we are with our 13 games, you know, Breakout, Canyon Bomber, Casino, Circus Atari, Demons to Diamonds, Night Driver, Steeplechase, Street Racer, Super Breakout, Video Olympics, Warlords, and our two arcade games, Pong and Warlords. Yes, we've got two arcade games and 11 Atari, licensed Atari, video games, which is pretty darn cool. So, what's so cool about this game? This system is that it comes with 13 games. That off the bat gives me very high hopes that it's okay. Plus it's Atari, plus it's got a couple of arcade games on it. I don't know how they managed to get them on, but okay, that's weird. One of the things I noticed is in the bottom right, I don't know if you guys can actually read that. I can't. You might be able to read it on a CRT television, but other than that, I can't. Just because I know the shapes of the words and I've seen them so often over the years, you've got 2004 Jack Specific Inc. developed by Digital Playground? I don't know. Does it say on the bottom? Let's cheat. Oh no, it doesn't say. We will never know the developer. It just says Jack Specific on it. That's a shame. But anyway, to the games. Let's start out with a simple one, Breakout. Now, what's cool about this Atari Plug and Play is that if you press the menu button, instead of going straight back to the menu, we won't start the game, it takes us to an Atari 2600 screen, which is really, really weird and cool. So you've got all these switches on the front, just like an Atari game, and if you go all the way to the back, you've got the power switch, which is exit game. You can go back to different game. All right, so you've got to change the TV type, which is really, really cool. You can change it between black and white and color. However, I don't believe this one actually has a difference. You've got left difficulty, so you can change the difficulty if you really want to. You got the right difficulty for the right game. Sometimes you'll be the right paddle and sometimes you'll be the left. Like I said, this is the one player variety, so it's really annoying. Yeah, game variation. I never understood that as a kid. I guess it makes the game harder? I don't know. And then you've got the restart game, which is really, really cool as well. So you've got some really, really cool options. And to get out of that, you just press the menu button again. Alright, so here we are with our paddle. God, the accuracy on this thing's great. Problem is, am I going to be great? So yeah, this is a Breakout. Very simplistic sounds. That's Atari in a nutshell. If you came here for really good music and stuff, you came to the wrong place. Atari 2600 is not known for their great soundtracks. I mean, you can make really good sounds with Atari beeps. If you want some of those, definitely give them a quick YouTube. Ooh. Apparently, I need to get good at the speed. The one great thing about this plug and play, especially, is that it's a great way to play these old Atari games with a paddle, because there's so many Atari games you cannot play very well with a D-pad. This is one of them. Breakout is garbage with a D-pad. But with this controller, especially, you've got way more accuracy. I just can't show that off too much because I am a garbage person that cannot play video games. But yeah, it's a really, really great, authentic recreation of this Atari Paddle game. It's really, really good. I am garbage. So anyway, I don't want to spend too long on each game. There are too many games to go through, and I want to go through them all. When it gets to too many games, you'll notice I tend to not go through them all, but hey, I'm actually going to try going through them all on this one. Alright, so I am the green guy, and we're bombing a lake, a canyon. We're bombing something. Basically, our objective is to get more points than this little red scrub lord over there. Unfortunately, it's very difficult to do. Because he's constantly dropping bombs, I'm trying to, and I'm just not doing very well. I would like to switch sides now, please. Because I want to get hold of that. On the other side, yes, I got some of it. Alright, destroy that tower part there. Destroy that. I'm trying to get as much points as possible. He's destroying me. The AI is completely destroying me. I am... Oh, now we've swapped sides, now that I don't want it. Oh, garbage game. Garbage game. This is actually a garbage game. It's not very fun. It's unfortunately for this plug and play, most of them suffer from the fact that they've got games that require two players or would be played better with two players, but the plug and play is only one player. This is one of those. There, like I said, there are a couple of variations of this console, this plug and play console. This is the one player variety. I would have preferred to get the two player variety so I could play with the girlfriend. But unfortunately, we don't have that, so you can just play this game over and over and be bored out your face. Yeah, that would be... Canyon Bombers is a lot more fun with other players playing against the... Casino? I'm no good at anything to do... Oh, God. Nope, I'm... Nope, not even going there because I don't understand that. So, I guess I skipped the game, don't me? You got Circus Atari. Oh, my God, I hated this game. Because it's so evil. No! Ah! Oh, God! No, I'm so sorry! I'm not sorry. Oh! Oh, yeah, you press the button to switch, don't you? Yeah, you press the button to switch. Okay. Oh, God, I hate this game, it's cruel! Woo! Yeah, ride the lightning! Ride the lightning! Ride the lightning! Oh! Oh, I think we're good. Haha! I can sit here all... I am so sorry. Well, that was fun. This is... I hate this game. I hate this game because I'm no good at it. No, I'm so sorry. All right, that's Circus Atari. Pretty fun. Again, more accurate with the paddle. Thank God. Not many plug and plays use the paddle controller. Not many at all. Even the Atari Flashback consoles do not use the paddle for these games at all. So... You won't be having a good time with that. I should have flipped that. I'm so sorry. I'm not good at this game. I never said I was. So yeah, that was Circus Atari. Don't want to spend too long on it. We'll stay until I die, which is inevitable. Oh, sick, called it. Next game. Demons to Diamonds. Oh, what's this game? Oh, is this like Space Invaders? I've never played this game before. I've never heard of it before. Oh, it's a little bit like Space Invaders, I guess? All right, so we got the paddle. Who's shooting at me? Wait, are these... Are the corpses shooting at me, or are they just coming in randomly? I'm trying to understand this game. I'm getting shot at by a corpse. How is the corpse shooting at me? That is a skull and crossbone, isn't it? Yeah, the... I'm getting better, but I'm just... It's because I... Oh, right, okay. So the longer you hold the button, the further it'll shoot out. So you can shoot the top. Let's try shooting the top right. You actually cannot shoot those dead corpses. You just gotta... Wait, can you or not? I don't know. I guess it's on a timer then? I don't know. We'll give that one a quick restart. Game reset. All right. Wait, you're dead. You're dead. What are you? Oh, you're dead too. Hey, see, this is what happens when you're in the garbage. Oh, crap. No! Stop shooting! Whatever you're doing, stop shooting. No! No! Damn corpses! Getting killed by corpses! This is, wait, is... Cause this, could I test this as a zombie game? I guess so. What happens when they shoot up? Yeah, I genuinely can't shoot it. I shoot it, but the bullets don't go through it. It's acting like a barrier. I'm just going to keep shooting it and see if it dies. Yeah, it doesn't die. It just acts like a barrier. Hmm. Definitely interesting. Keep getting shot. Not many lives. But yeah, this is a pretty fun, like, Space Invaders type game. It's a lot different. It's got, like, a pseudo, like 3D idea behind it. Like, more isometric. I just gotta... What the hell are they doing? Die! Oh! Twitchy! Twitchy! No! Go away! Damn corpse! You're dead. You're dead. You're dead. You're dead. You're dead. You're dead. No! There's so many corpses everywhere! I can't move. I'm trapped. I'm trapped! Go! Die, you! Over there. Die. Nope. Oh! Oh, we actually did it. Yes, so this is arguably one of the most fun games on here. Oh, snap. So this is a contender for one of the most fun games on here. You got really twitchy. You got it really good. I suppose you could change the difficulties and stuff. So that's pretty done. Darn cool. So that's... What was that? Demons to Diamonds? I never heard of that. I need to get that. And if I've already got it, I need to play it more. Night Driver. What? No? Okay, so it's the... Oh, God! Ah! Oh, my God, this is so horrifying to play! Ah! Ah! This is like drunk driving at nighttime! So you've got to hold the button. Did I crash? I guess I did. Oh, my God. Oh, my... What the hell? All right, I'm trying to turn! I crashed into a vehicle. Yeah, this is drunk driving at nighttime. You call it Night Driver or you want. It's drunk driving. Admit it. Admit it, game. It's drunk driving. Alright, so apparently we're driving in America. We're on the right-hand side. Oh, apparently I crashed into the barrier. I like how the posts are like fences. This is so disorienting to play. It must be disorienting to you to even... You're wondering what the hell's going on watching this. I'm trying to stay in between the dots, because the dots are given like a pseudo 3D environment. It constantly looks like we're driving uphill at an angle. Left and right, constantly. This is really, really... Oh, damn. Oh! I think all that beeping is cars, literally, honking their horns. Oh, damn. Oh! Hey, I'm doing quite well! I'm doing okay! Oh. Oh. Well, that's the end of that before I puke myself into... Oh, damn, my eyes! Okay, that was disorienting. That was not enjoyable for my eyes, but it was intense as hell. Steeplechase. I remember this game. I don't know how to play it. Do I just have to keep spanking the pony? Who am I? Green Man? Whoop! all right, I got this. I'm the green one. I'm the green one. Get out of my way! Yeah! Yeah! Paddle doesn't seem to do anything. Wait, what? What does the paddle do? The paddle does something. What does it do? I guess it tells you how big you want the jump to be? Yeah, I think it determines how big the jump is. I'll just stick to the largest. Seems to be easiest way to win. Come on, we're winning. Keep it going. Keep it going, Dan. Go on, Dan. Go on, Dan. Go on. Go on. Go on, my son. Go on. Go on. Go on! Get in there! Yeah! Oh, no! Go on! Get! Recover! Go! No! Keep going! Keep going! You got this! Dan, do it! Go! Go! Wait, how far are we going for? Go! Go on! Go on! Go on! No one can beat you, Dan! You are indestructible! Oh, crap! You are indestructible! Oh, come on! The jump's appearing right in front of me! How can I react to this? I can't react to this! Fuck it! Go! Okay, that was fun. It's like one of those little arcade games. That sounds kind of cool. So yeah, we won. Go me. Let's try another game. Street Racer. Oh, another... What? All right, let's go. I think you gotta hold the button to speed up. Oh, oh. That's not what I asked for. I'm getting beat by an AI that doesn't work. So this is another example of a two-player game that's garbage. I'm getting beat by the freaking AI that's not moving. What is this? Why are the cars coming in my direction? Leave me alone! You garbage bloody player. Whoa, 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 whoa. I'm staying in this corner. I'm safe here. No! I'm getting beat by an AI. Oh, I think I've literally just managed to sneak the lead. Oh, really close right now. I'm getting beat by an int. Look at that. The other character, the player's not moving. They're not moving at all. They only move when they get hit. There is no AI there at all. I mean, sure, it's an old Atari game, but seriously, this is not fun. This game is not enjoyable. It'd be more fun against, obviously, another player, but then again, as you can see, it's still really close. You're not given enough time to react to them. This game's garbage. All right, that game is garbage. It'd be more fun with other players, obviously, but it's still garbage. Even if you played with another person, I mean, playing with a stick and a stone and poking it would be more enjoyable with another person. So, I hate using that excuse saying, oh, it'd be fun with another person. Anyway, Super Breakout, enough ranting about that garbage game. That was actually a really garbage game. Breakout, though, Breakout is great. I love Breakout. I used to be really good at Breakout. I used to play it on the PC all the time with a paddle controller. Yeah. I think it was just a joystick. I can't remember. I would have been like five to eight years old at the time. I used to play an old PC version of it. I wish I could find it. I can't find it anywhere. Basically, it was a version of Breakout where it made pictures. Like an ice cream cone and stuff. Or an ice cream sundae. I can't really remember. Maybe even a beer? I can't really remember. I definitely remember the ice cream, though. And you used to actually destroy the pictures with the paddle. This was during the 90s, and there were so many Breakout clones, it'd be impossible to find now. But, yeah, I used to play that non-stop, and I used to be so good at it. Anyway, this is Super Breakout. If you enjoy these games, you should definitely keep playing them. But for the purpose of this video, I can't keep playing it because, one, it's not enjoyable to watch, really. I wouldn't say it's enjoyable to watch. Let's get up there. If you get up there, you'll be able to just beat the crap out of the top. Get back up there. Go on. Break it. No! Damn messed up. Nope. Wrong way. Whatever. But, yeah, that's Super Breakout. I don't want to spend too long on these games. All right, next up, we've got Video Olympics. Is this Pong? Video Olympics. Is this meant to be tennis, but in reality it's just a Pong clone? Damn AI. Come at me, bruh. You can't stop this. You can't stop this. What do you mean, no? Revenge! Excitement. Pong. This is Pong. Pong with a fat paddle. Oh no, I just gave him the advantage! No! Go! Damn. Go. Yeah, hit it back. He never saw that coming. Damn! Go. No! No! No, I rotated the wrong way! Ah, bogus. But yeah, that's Pong. I'll be showing you more Pong later. Warlords. There we go. Here we get to the interesting ones. We've got Warlords. Now, Warlords. A great four-player game. A great four-player game. Who am I? Oh, I'm brown on this one. Okay. So this is essentially Breakout. Essentially. It is a four-player Breakout. It's incredible. You're basically just protecting your kingdom, your castle walls. I hit that back into my own wall. You cannot destroy me. This is yet another game which obviously would benefit so much more from having more controllers. All they had to do was put a controller port on this console. That's all they had to do. They didn't even have to ship it with another controller. I could have supplied the controllers. I'm not too bothered. But I know they did make a two-player variant of this, but the fact that they didn't straight off the bat bothers me. Because it's not really that enjoyable, one player. I am not taking part in this. Oh, there we go. I got a hit. I think everyone hates the blue one more. Blue and green. Yeah, it's blue and green that are at it. Oh, hey! I resent you hitting me. Go away. No! I got revenge on you. So, yeah. I mean, it's enjoyable for what it is, but it's not exactly... Well, I'm winning. I'm winning by not taking part in this battle. Yeah, I have the most soldiers. No! Get away from me! Hey, I got him! Oh my god, we took him out. Was that me that took him out? Shit. I'm literally... I need to protect that side. Wait, did he swing it into himself? Oh, damn! It's just me and Blue now! Oh, damn! No! No! It's mine. How do you catch the ball? You just press the button when you get it. Oh, I'm so close to getting him. It's RNG now. It's RNG now. Yeah! Don't care. Get out of my way. I won. Don't care. Run away. All right. So, yeah, that was Warlords. And now we're playing Pong. How do we start? Oh, game! You see that shit? What was that? What was... Don't you beep at me! You son of a bitch! Grr! That beep. That's horrible. The original Pong on... Arcade. I'm getting my butt kicked. That, what are you doing? Put it down there! What are you doing? You're helping them! You're helping them! How dare you? Let me score. I'm getting beat by a mentally challenged Pong player. I love how they gave him a serving down the center. Disgusting.
You're drawing now.
Alright, let's do this. I don't know where the top of the screen is. There? Why do I keep hitting it straight? I keep hitting it straight. Oh, I'm being an idiot. No! No, I'm getting beat by the brain dead AI. Wait, he won? Fine. All right, next up we've got Warlords, the last game on this system. It is literally just the arcade version of the Warlords game we played. Press play start. I am. What? I'm blue now? I'm blue now. Okay, there's a dragon. Don't shoot it at me. Don't you do it! I said don't do it, and what did he do? He did it. It's like he hates me in particular. This is a lot better to look at. I love the retroness of the Atari, but god damn, the graphics were so simple. It bothers me. But that was the best of the time, so... Oh, what the hell was that? How do you catch it? How do you catch it? Someone tell me how to catch it. This'll be posthumous, won't it? Damn it! Did I just press the button? No, I clearly don't. It's weird. Hey! Those purples and greens are working against me! Get over there! Get over here! Just go crazy! Just go crazy! Just go crazy! You know, that was probably... This is probably, like, my only strategy when I used to play this. I don't think it was in the arcades. Well, you just realize I'm going after you? Yeah, they're working together, them. Get out of it. Get out of it. I'll destroy all your forces. All of your soldiers. All of your men. What is this? What is this? Why me? Go away. I don't want this. Leave me alone. You leave my... I love how I'm getting beat up. What the hell is this? Like, they're all after me. They're all after... Rude. It's because I'm not the only human here. Racists. You're just a race of arcade circuitry. Yeah, I'm circuitrist. Circuitrist. Is that a word? It is now. Alright. Alright, so we're winning. Oh god! Oh no! My crown! My kingdom! My kingdom for attendee! No! Oh, no! 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 Oh, you! I saw that third one! No. Rude. Game is against me. Right, where's my letters? Here we go. Right, it goes backwards. Alright, yeah. F. U. Nope, that's the sound I'm making. So, yeah, let's go out for some final thoughts on this Atari Paddle plug and play. Let's do it.
Alrighty, so what are my final thoughts on the Atari Paddle plug and play system? It would be a massive recommendation from me if it was two player. I keep mentioning that because that is the biggest con of this system. All it needed was a control port somewhere on this system, maybe even there, I don't care. Somewhere. If it had another controller port on it, I could have plugged another controller into it. I know there's two-player variants out there, so if you can find the two-player variant of this, it's a no-brainer. Pick it up, buy it, play it. It's brilliant. Buy it for your kids. Buy it for you and your spouse. Buy it for you and your kid. Do whatever. Just buy it, play it, enjoy it. It's really fun. If, however, you enjoy the games you saw on this review, then definitely pick this up, even if it's the one player variant, because a lot of the games on there are really, really fun and will provide hours of entertainment. You could just sit there and enjoy this on just a few AA batteries. I think it's 4 AA batteries. Just pick it up and play it. It's so accurate. It's better than the Atari Flashback. If you can get a paddle controller for the Atari Flashback, definitely get it. But otherwise, this is the far superior controller for the Atari system for paddle type games such as Breakout and Pong. Really, really fun, really, really entertaining, and, you know, I find it really hard not to recommend this. It's got 13 games on it, 11 licensed Atari games. I'm just going to say 10, because no one's going to play the casino one, admit it, you're not. So you've got 10 fantastic Atari games, and 2 arcade games, which are really, really good, and if you can get the two-player variant, you can play Pong with a friend, or a spouse, or your kid. You can literally do that. You can play that. Play Arcade Warlords. That'd be intense and awesome and fun. And that's what this offers. So if you can enjoy it one player, go for it. It's definitely worth it. Especially if you can get it dirt cheap. If you find it in a charity shop or a pawn shop for like $1.99, grab it. Grab it. It's so fun and it's great and it looks great on your shelf and everything. Just look at that. It's so good. So yeah, pick it up. It's fun. And try and get the two-player variant, or 4. I don't know if there was more than 2. I know there was a two-player variant, but I really don't think there'll be a 3 or 4-player variant. I don't know, just keep an eye out for it. So yep, that's the Atari Paddle plug-and-play review. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Let me know what you think of this device. It's bloody brilliant. I love it. But yeah, it definitely kills it. It's one player. Let me know what you guys think. I will see you guys next time. Take care, survivors.